The thing that I feared the most has happened. I've fallen deeply in love. Not with a person, but with a place. How is this possible? I've only been here for a short time, and now I can't imagine trying to leave. I love everything. The way the light reflects on the cobblestones after it rains, the bickering of elderly people at the market, and the feeling that time is moving at a much slower pace. I know that I must leave. This was only meant to be temporary, but I'm scared that with my return will come a deep depression. How can I go back to what I have now that I know what I could have?
Dearest friend, I write to you with great eagerness and excitement. I'm having the most splendid time here. I feel that this is a dream rather than reality. I hate to use this phrase, but I want to pinch myself to make sure that it's all real. Jim and I have been acting like giddy school children that have just been told a secret. We have taken ridiculous pictures and have indulged in every type of delight while here. We are, after all, on holiday, and I don't feel that I need to justify any of my actions. I won't tell Jim this, but of course I can tell you. I even met another man here. We've secretly seen each other 3 times now, and will continue until Jim gets suspicious. Jim is always so blissfully unaware that I'm sure he'll never suspect a thing and we can continue meeting uninterrupted. You absolutely must vacation with me here soon. The men here are not too bright, but exceedingly handsome, and once you become bored with them, you can just go back home and forget all about them. You must consider it. See you on my return.
I'm here alone with no one to confide in, so I'll write to you. I thought this postcard would give my letter an air of cheer, despite the hollowness that I feel. I'm in Cornwall, but I don't know a soul here. I hope that Florence is just as well as it always is. Cornwall is cold and wet, and not a place to meet people easily. Now that I'm here, I'm not sure why I came at all. There's nothing for me here. The wilderness is the one thing I have found comfort in. It's so truly wild here. The trees and the rocks, they are all so vastly different. These differences can only distract for a short time before I return to the sorrow of my own thoughts. I know that you might not care about my feelings. In fact, you might simply throw this silly postcard away upon receiving it. Yes, I have considered this fact, but I needed to tell you. Tell someone about what I've been doing in Cornwall, no matter how pathetic it might be.
You will never guess what happened. A huge businessman, Tiziano Montagani, got arrested in Firenze a week ago. Apparently he has been embezzling millions. The press had a field day when he was arrested, and guess who was right there in the middle of it? Me! And I took the picture that was on the front page of the paper in yesterday's papers. Enclosed is a copy of the winning shot. Tons of copies have been printed already, but I thought you would want one of your own. I will send a copy of the paper as soon as I can. I was so surprised that they chose my picture. I mean, the agent arresting Montagani looks absolutely bewildered. I had many others, but they like this children. One best.
We
this is one of the biggest
scandals
to hit Frenzy in a very long
time. We are counting down
the
days until
Let's
we will see
curse
your smiling
for very, very
again.
Long time. Enjoy the
Verona
picture and
expect wonderful.
Our arrival soon.
We must take you here soon. Daddy and I have been exploring every part of Verona and haven't found a single thing that we don't like about this place. It has been nice to return to the city after our stint with the wilderness. We went camping and fishing, and I don't think Duke could have been happier. He tried to catch fish in the river and wanted to play fetch with every stick in the woods. He's having lots of fun, but I know he misses you very much, just like we do. I hope that you have been good to Mrs. Sanders. If you haven't been, we'll hear all about it, and there will be no trip to Verona for any of you. I thought I would send you this outrageous picture of Daddy in the great outdoors. Doesn't he blend in well? Try not to miss us too much. We will be home before you know it.
Hi, Mommy. Auntie told me I'd better write to you since I have been gone for 2 whole weeks now. Everything has been so much fun, but very strange. Buildings here are such strange shapes and painted in the oddest colors imaginable. People dress weird, too, and it has been bitter cold. Auntie insists that I at least try everything that is put on my plate, no matter how weird it might look. It all tastes very good, but nothing like the way you and Grandma cook. Everyone here is so ugly. But at least they're nice. I can never understand what they're saying, but I usually get a pat on the back, a wave, or a smile from everyone I meet. I hope the weather gets warmer, or I will want to end my visit much sooner than expected. I hope you and Dad are having fun at home. I hope the fighting between you stops, too. I know it is sometimes my fault that you fight, and maybe me being away will fix everything. I really hope it does.
I have found Oz, but it goes by a different name, Switzerland. Everyone is so happy all the time, and things literally move like clockwork. Upon my arrival, I thought it was entertaining, adorable even, but now I just find it weird. How can people be this happy all the time? Take the postcard, for example. Everyone is smiling, and not one person is out of place. Maybe it is the cynic in me, but I really cannot believe that happiness like this is real. The scenery has been a nice change, but provides only a short break from cheeriness that I find so unsettling. I only have a few more days in Geneva before I head to Zurich, and I hope I will find it less creepy. I realize that you are planning a trip here in a few months, and it really is a lovely place. It might be my own delusions that are giving me this impression, but I thought I would give you my honest thoughts about Switzerland. I will let you know how Zurich is.
I'll be
it
waiting
has
for
to
you.
Be better than this.
You're in London now, but I heard you'll be going to France in a few days, and I'll be there. This is not a matter of choice. You must come home, or we will no longer be anything but acquaintances. You would be a fool not to come. But if you're foolish enough, don't think that I'll be there, waiting for you when you return home. You will come home to nothing. I've sat back and watched your foolishness with a passive annoyance. But no, you must make a choice. If you don't come back, there'll be nothing for me to go back either. You are the one that has kept me from losing my motivation. I do not wish to imagine my existence without you, but you've left me no choice. I will persist without you, and my independence is not one that will be lost because of a silly girl that has lost all sense of practicality. For your sake, hope to see you in France. Send word of where you're staying. If I do not hear from you then, I expect to never hear from you again. It will not be me that suffers.
I thought you would like to see this photo of Dad. We had it taken a few months ago. I'm worried about him. He is here, but not all here. It seems that he is often not conscious of his surroundings, and when he is, he seems exceedingly sad. Mom is no better off than Dad. As his health diminishes, so does her spirit. If we lose Dad, I don't know what will become of Mom. Having this nice photograph of him gives me some peace of mind. As Dad's health declines, I've begun to think of his legacy. It's not something that most of us consider until we are approaching death, or someone close to us is nearing the end of this life. I feel that this photograph is a way of cementing Father's existence in history. When he has passed on, we will be able to say, this was my father. He lived and was a good man. Please keep this photograph safe and plan on visiting very, very soon. There might not be much time left.